This is what's nuts about hunting out here. I just saw a gator go in over there, in that bend, and I've got to jump in this bend. So at least I know it's over there, but it still doesn't give you much faith, does it? So we saw that gator go in right over there, and I'm walking up the bank, and I noticed that we've got gator slides right here. You can see where the claws went right there, and it's sliding up this bank multiple times a day, I guess. It's making some pretty large slides. And so I'm really hoping that it's not in there.
Getting closer to where that gator might live, so, whew, we'll see. So in this hole behind me are some very large mastodon bones. The problem is they are so delicate, there's no way I could remove them without breaking them. So if it's even possible, if I want to recover these bones, we might bring some jacket material and take them out in the peat it seems to be encased in and put them immediately into jackets, or maybe even try to stabilize them here. But that's a really long shot. They might just have to stay buried in that peat for ad infinitum. They've been in there for a while, they can stay in there for a little longer, but really cool hole, really beautiful day. And I got more hiking to do and one more spot to check. So this is a really beautiful bend in the river. You can see the nice shallows over here, but if you look right over here, there is a deep bend, a sharp cut in the river, and that sharp cut has caused some erosion. And hopefully in that hole right there, there might be some interesting fossils for us to uncover.
Mastodon Tooth! Woo! It's deep, current strong, but that's a Mastodon Tooth. And it looks very, very nice. Oh my god. Yeah!
I was giving up. That's the last piece of this bend. And I'm really hopeful that it is in really good condition. The root's sticking up, and it looks like it's the whole tooth, and it's an adult tooth. And this is the last spot I'm checking today, so. Woohoo! I'm going down.
This is awesome. This is awesome. It is a mastodon tooth, and it is nice. We're gonna have to be really careful with it getting it home. It just got exposed, and it's got a delicate crack right here, so Let's get this on the bank and let's get this ready to take home.
So as it turns out, I did end up getting very lucky today. This is an incredible example of an adult mastodon tooth. We can tell it's an older individual based on how much wear is on the surface of the tooth. Normally, these loafs up here would have been about this high, but over the course of going through hundreds of pounds of shrubs, legumes, and fruits, every day, it's worn its tooth down. Now, mastodons replace their teeth horizontally rather than vertically, so we have an interesting amount of wear right here on the back of the tooth, and that's where the tooth behind this one was pressing into it. And it was pressing into it with such force that it wore into the tooth. So that would have been a really interesting position in the jaw. If we can find the other tooth, they'll clink together, and I bet that would look so wicked. Now, we did manage to get to this tooth just in time because it's delicate. This ivory is very delicate, and you can see where it's cracking through here. And so the river was already taking it apart. It lost a chunk of the ivory root right up here where my finger is. But we got here just in time, and as long as I can hike this a few miles out of here, it'll be an incredible addition to my fossil collection. I love that polished surface on these teeth. Really, really incredible fossil. In front of that incredible mastodon tooth, we also did find this perfect example of an extinct bison tooth. Now, this wicked tooth can be identified by what's called a stylet, and it's this bump of enamel right here. Modern camelids and extinct camelids do not have it, so we can differentiate this tooth from the extinct camels and llamas that used to be in Florida based off that feature. And to me, it's an incredible reminder of the extinct animals, the diversity of them that used to be in Florida. This is Bison antiquus, antiquities bison, and it was about 15 to 20% larger than the modern bison. Do you see that over there? That is the earth letting out a gentle fart. So that's actually methane. This is a swamp. The river cuts through the swamp, but all throughout here there's methane trapped in it. And so if you step on something wrong, it'll bubble and that gas will come out, and that's that smell. Now that methane is the classic swamp smell that people hate. Personally though, I have so many good memories attached to it. When I smell it, it actually jumpstarts those memories out here fossil hunting, and weirdly enough, I enjoy it. I'll be honest, I almost gave up on today's hunt. Those mastodon vertebrae we found earlier were cool, but I cannot believe that right behind us is where we found that mastodon tooth. It is such a humbling thought to think that I am the first person to ever see, hold, touch this incredible fossil. The sun is finally starting to set, and I have a very long hike out of here. If you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to like it, share it, and subscribe to the channel. And as always, keep on digging science.
For today's video, we are giving away this set of fossil shark teeth representing 10 different species, all of which can be identified with this included guide to the common marine fossils of the southeastern United States.
All you have to do to enter is leave a comment below describing your favorite of our fossil hunting adventures.